My first weapon of choice, of course, since I started out online as a service provider offering web and graphic design, has got to be Photoshop. I use it every day, and I couldn't function without it. If you make videos, you're going to be pleased to know that you can use Photoshop to make your videos too. It has a full range of editing features, and you can adjust the colors and use most of the filters just like you're working on an image. Just make sure your computer is strong enough to handle the workload. I also use Photoshop to make all of my transparent PNGs that I import into Sony Vegas as a transition slide, a box cover, lower third, or any other graphic that you've seen in my videos. Learning how to use Photoshop properly will open up an unlimited amount of creative possibilities for you, and if you can also make things look good, it can put money in your pocket too. If I didn't use Photoshop, I would use GIMP. It's limited, but it gets the job done, and it's free. For websites, landing pages, etc., I use WordPress. My VIP area that I always push in my videos is all built using WordPress too. And of course, a link to that will be in the description if you want to check it out. If you learn how to set up WordPress properly, install themes, and how to do some basic theme tweaks, knowing how to use WordPress can make you money also. For screen recording, I use Camtasia. It's extremely easy to use, and you can even use it to edit your videos and key out green screens if you want. The basic features are easy to use, but if you really want to know the ins and outs of it, check out Lon Naylor. He's certified by TechSmith, which is the company that makes Camtasia, and he'll teach you everything that you need to know. I'll put a link to his site in the description. I recommend getting on his mailing list too, because he gives away a lot of cool things that you can use in Camtasia and when you're making videos in general. If you do anything with large amounts of photos or graphics and you need to rename them in some kind of sequential order or something and you haven't automated the process yet, you need to. Depending on what I'm batch renaming, I'll either use CK Rename, which is free, or Adobe Bridge, which is not free, but it comes bundled with Photoshop. Both options are extremely easy to use, and they save you tons and tons and tons of time because you don't have to sit there and rename each file one by one, which can almost drive you crazy. For videos, I use Sony Vegas Pro. I started using it back somewhere around Sony Vegas 8, and I fell in love with it, and I've stuck with it as it's gotten cooler and cooler over the years. It's excellent for color correction, but you can also do some basic animation with it. Don't get me wrong, it doesn't compare to After Effects when it comes to animation, but for what I use it for, things flying in and out of the screen, etc., it does everything that I need, and more. If you're self-hosting your videos, you want to keep the file size as small as possible to keep costs down. For this, I use Handbrake, and to be upfront with you, I don't know the ins and outs of Handbrake. All I know is that if I run my videos through it on its default setting, they still look great, but the file size is drastically reduced. If you work while you travel, or you're in a country with slower internet, a smaller file size is really going to come in handy when it comes time to upload your video. For taking the noise out of audio and leveling things out, I used to use Audacity, which is free, but I recently found Adobe Audition. It took me a little bit of time to get the functions ironed out. As a matter of fact, one of the first videos on this channel has messed up audio because I was learning how to use Audition with headphones on and mixed to using headphones instead of testing it across different headphones or speakers to make sure that it was solid before I made it live. But oh well, live and learn. Now that I've gotten the functions figured out, I think the audio sounds pretty decent. What do you think? For royalty-free music, I either make it myself using software called Reason, or I use Audio Jungle, which the link is in the description. For the tracks I make myself, I'm slowly loading them into my VIP area so you can use them too without any copyright headaches. If you do anything at all that requires color, which is pretty much anything creative, then you have to check out color.adobe.com.